Hello guys, welcome back to the fourth video in this series on OpenCV. So in this tutorial, we're going to go ahead and learn how to simply draw different shapes, put text on images and stuff like that, how to draw circles, rectangles, write on images and stuff like that. So this is what we're going to be covering in this tutorial. So let me just quite quickly go ahead and create a simple file here. I'm going to call it basic _04.py file. So instead of this basic.py file, I'm going to go ahead and simply import CV2 as we usually do. And once I have CV2 imported, I'm simply going to go ahead and simply read an image file, and on that image file we will learn how to draw circles, how to draw lines, how to draw rectangles, and how to put text on it, right? So let me go ahead and read that image. I'm going to say image is going to be equals to a folding, so I'm going to say cv2 dot imread. So imread, so by now you guys are probably familiar with this. So we need to write the path to that image, and which is going to be the .forward/images. I think I called it images /image 1.jpg, just like that. So once I have this done read, I'm simply going to go ahead and display the content of this image out. So I'm going to simply go ahead and simply say cv2 dot imshow, and simply say that image, and then I'm going to, sorry, I need to write in the title, it's going to be the image, and then I'm going to go ahead and say image, just like this. So once I have this done, this image showed, I can simply say cv2 dot weight key. So weight key, just like this, and I'm providing 1. So I think it's 1 or 0. I need providing actually 0 yet. Wait until we press a key on our keyboard to quit out of that. Okay. Yeah, that's basically it. So let's go ahead and try to run it. Let's make sure that the image is being displayed. So I'm just going to do an ls, and you can see we have the basic _4.py file there. So I'm going to say python 3, and let me just use sudo so that you guys can get the default display. So I'm going to say basic then sudo 4.py. If you're on Windows, you don't have to simply say sudo. If you're on Windows, you don't have to use sudo. So yeah, so I'm just run this again. Okay, but it's gonna be python 3, so just get that right, python 3, and then run that. Yeah, so this is now open and displayed for us, this image as we see it right here. So yeah, great, everything works. So now let's go and actually learn how to actually put some text on this image. The first thing we're going to learn is how to draw a simple line on the image. So to draw a simple line, I'm just going to say image, and this is going to be close to cv2 dot line. So I'm going to simply set cv2 dot line, and you print on which image you want to draw. So you say image, and you're going to say image, right, passing that argument. And we can go ahead and say the first point, so pt the pt1, and it's going to be the first point where the like image has 2 points, right? The beginning of the line, and then a line has 2 points, right? The end of the line, and then the other end of the line. So we need probably the first point of the line, we're going to say 0, 0, right? So we're going to start from 0, 0, which is going to be the edge of our image, right? So imagine this was our image, the edge of the image is going to be here, okay? And then you're going to also go and provide point 2, and the point 2 is going to be equals to the following. So point 2 is going to be equals to let's say 170. I just got these values earlier, so when I was preparing these videos. So I'm going to say 1270. Let's see how that works. If it doesn't, I'll probably change these values, okay? Because I didn't want to waste you guys time trying to get those values, okay? So I'm gonna say we can actually get those values if you want. So I'm just gonna comment out the code for now, and simply go in my terminal and run the code again. So once I have this running, so we can go in here, and it doesn't actually display the x and the y axis. So I'm going to go ahead and simply quit this for now, and then just run this without the sudo, okay? So let me just run this command without using sudo. So I'm going to say python 3, and then let me just delete the sudo part so they can get the coordinates of the images, okay? So now I can see I have the coordinates right here at the bottom. You can see when I move my mouse around, I can get the coordinates. So this is going to be 0, 0 here, we're going to start from, and you're going to move all the way until here, yeah, which is about 270 and 834 32. Great. So once I have that, I'm going to quit this and then go back into my VS code right here, and simply uncomment out this part of the code. So I'm going to go until 270 to 834, right, which was the value we got. So yeah, so I'm going to those each line must have a color, can have a color. So I'm going to say color, and the color is going to be a BGR color. So it's color, I'm going to use 255 0, 255, just any random color that you want. And once I have this, I'm going to specify the thickness of this. So thickness, I can specify the thickness of the line to be maybe 4. Yeah, that's all we want. Specify the thickness of the line, the starting point, the ending point, and then the color along with the thickness. So that's all we want. So once I have this, I can go ahead and display the image, right? So let me try to run this, and let's run this code again. So now you can see we have the line being drawn until here, right? So yeah, that's basically the line, and I think the line doesn't actually reach the end. So let's go ahead and try to add some more values to it. Let's say 80. 80, yeah, let's see how it goes. And let me just run this again. Let's see, maybe hopefully, yeah, you can see now it completes, passes through there. So you can see we can draw a line here just by using OpenCV. Great. So once I have this, then I can go back in my VS Code. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you how to simply draw how to draw a rectangle on an image. So to draw a rectangle is quite very similar and easy. Okay, so I'm going to say image, and the image is going to be cv2.rectangle. So rectangle, rectangle, and we want to do rectangle on what image? So it's like the image as an image, the image that we have from Appian, which already has the line already. And then we want to give it the when doing a rectangle, we are going to specify two things. Okay, 2 points. The first point is going to be the top. This is going to be the top left corner of the rectangle, right? The top left corner point of the rectangle, and the second point is going to be the top the bottom right part of the rectangle. Okay, so this might be a bit confusing, but don't worry, I'm just going to go ahead, draw this, and then I'll use the image to explain to you that. Okay, I think the visual explanation will be much better. So I'm going to say 500. You can just specify any point you want, but I'm going to say 500, which is going to be the starting point, the top left part of the rectangle. And then I'm going to say 0.2, and the 0.2 can be anything. So 0.2, for the 0.2, I'm going to say 800, just like this. And then for the color, I'm going to specify the color, and the color is going to be the following. So the color is going to be 250, 0, 250. So just like that. So 250, 0, 250. And once I have that specified, I'm also going to go and specify the thickness of this rectangle. So I'm going to say thickness, and thickness, I'm just going to say thickness to be 2. Leave that thickness to default to 2. Okay. Yeah. That's all I need. Once I have this, I can go ahead and display this rectangle on the image. So let's actually go ahead and run the code again. Clear my terminal and run the code again. Now hopefully we should see the rectangle, and the rectangle is just the one right here. So this is the first point we provided, which is the top left part of the image, and this is the bottom right part of the image. So those are the 2 points. So this is the first point, and this is the second point. Okay. Great. So this is the second point, and this here is the first point. Okay, so that's of those two images. So that's simply how you can simply go ahead and simply draw a simple rectangle. So now let's go ahead and simply learn how to draw a cycle. Now let's go. So I'm going to say image, and then it's going to be cv2.cycle. So I'm going to say image, on which image I want to draw the cycle from is the image that we have from above, which has the line and the rectangle included. So to draw a cycle, you have to say the center of the cycle, like where it should start from, right? The center of a cycle, like if you did mathematics, you probably know what the center of the cycle is. So we say 200 by 200. If you go on the image and you go 200 on the X and 200 on the Y, that's where the center of the cycle is going to be, okay? And I'm also going to provide the radius of the cycle, and the radius is going to be the following. So you can see that the radius is going to be 40, right? How far the cycle moves out, okay? And then we can simply go ahead and simply get the color of that cycle. We can see the color, we can specify the color that we want. So the color that I want in this specific case is going to be 250, 0, 250, like the other colors that we have used. Feel free to use any color that you're comfortable using, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and simply say the thickness of this cycle. So the thickness I'm going to use, I can say thickness is 4, and let's see how it looks when you say thickness is 4. So I'm going to go back here and simply run my code again, and the thickness 4, you get this cycle right here. Great. So I'm going to quit that, go back in here. You can also say cv2.field. So if you say cv2.field as a thickness, then cv2.field as a thickness, then the whole cycle is going to get filled, like get colored. So let me just show you how it's going to look like. So you should get the whole cycle should now be colored like this. Great. So once we have this done, let's go ahead and see the last part, which is going to go, we're going to go ahead and learn how to write text on an image. Okay, so I'm going to say cv2.put text. So let's say put and then text, just like this. So we want to specify where you want to put the text. So I'm going to say image, and it's going to be the image, and then you want to specify the text that you want to put. So I'm going to say text, and the text is going to be the following. So I'm going to say hello world, just like this, and I can just do this. Yes, that's going to be our text. And now we're going to go and specify the origin, like where the text should originate from, and this is going to be coordinates. So we're going to say 200 by 300. Okay, that's when the text is going to start from, just below the cycle. okay, and you're going to say the font face, and the font face is going to be equals to the following. So the font face is going to be equals to cv2 dot let's say font underscore Ashley. I think it should be like this. If I get this Ashley, I think it's gonna be like this. There are many fonts that come with that come with OpenCV. I'm just going to use this font right here. Yeah, that's all I want, and I want the font scale. So I'm going to say font scale. Let me just say the scale of the font, and I'm going to use the scale of the font to be, let's say, 2. And I can say color. I don't know if I can say color here, and I can say the color to be 250, comma 0, comma 250. Let's see how it goes. And then I think we can now specify the thickness. Let's say 2, and let's say, what about the fill? But like the thickness, I think we should just leave it for now. This should be fine for now. Let's try to run it and let's see if we get any errors. I actually forget a bit of the parameters. Yeah, so we got an error right here. So that error, that value right there, I think should be some value. I didn't actually get the value, so let me take a look at it. Yeah, so I actually took a look at it, and this should be thickness. Okay, so thickness, you have to say thickness is gonna be 2. So sorry for that, I forgot the name of that parameter. So it's thickness, and if I run it now, we should now see the text on that image. So we got another error here. We got this font. Yeah, I'm not actually sure of the font color, so let me just take a look at this font color and I'll be back. Yeah, so we got the font color here wrong. So let me just I think it's font, let me just go in here, and I think it's underscore simplex, if I'm not wrong. So simplex, just like this. I think that's the font color. So let me just run it. In case we get this wrong, we can just take a quick look at it on Google. Okay, yeah, so we got it right, and this is how we can put text. So we have hello world and then dot 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 exclamation mark. Yeah, so that's basically it, how we can simply write the different text content on our image. Okay, now we can also specify the line type, and you can just say the line type if you want. So you can say line type, and you can say the line type is going to be cv2.line underscore AA, just like this. So yeah, that's basically what we can do, and I'm just going to go in here and simply run the code. And yeah, you can see we have the hello world, and it's being formatted with the line type properly. It looks a bit better without the line type. Yeah, so that's basically it. And for this line type, I'm not really sure about the arguments. There are a lot of values you can use here. So quickly take a quick look at the documentation, and it should give you more details in case you're interested in more about the different line types. Okay, so that's basically it. So we learned how to simply draw a line on an image, draw a rectangle, draw different cycles, and then also put text on an image. So yeah, so that's all I wanted us to discuss in this video. So in the next video, we're going to do look at how to deal with a color detector and color picker. So we're going to do that in the next video. So thank you for watching, guys. If you enjoyed it so far, kindly consider liking this video, subscribing to the YouTube channel, and sharing this content with anyone who you think might find it helpful. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Keep safe.